a large crowd at Rosacuta Extreme Park for the finals of the men's ski cross. Three elimination rounds, the top two skiers in each race would progress to the next phase. 31 athletes in the field with their sights set on the gold medal. The Olympic champion Michael Schmidt had been forced to withdraw at the last minute, a recurrence of the injury problems which have affected the Swiss skier since he won this freestyle event in Vancouver in 2010. So, in his absence, the race was on to succeed him as Olympic champion. Jean-Frédéric Chapuis of France, wearing the red bib, had been one of the fastest qualifiers and made a confident start to his challenge. He was joined in the quarterfinals by Jonathan Meadle of France in the yellow bib. This freestyle skiing event is unpredictable. Travelling at high speed, hazardous. Mishaps during the course of racing, inevitable, and these finals would produce their share of drama. All four skiers managed to finish this race in the first of the knockout rounds. How they avoided falling down was due to their skill and courage, aided by a slice of luck.
Ouais, bravo! Allez, bravo!
Somehow they stayed on their feet and there was a photo finish. John Eklund of Sweden in the yellow bib edging out Arno Bovalenta of France in green, with Mikael Forslund of Sweden missing out in third place. The first quarterfinal would have a chaotic finish. The field included Victor Erling Norberg of Sweden. The fastest of the qualifiers, the top seed, was wearing the red bib. Erling Norberg strongly tipped for a medal after an impressive season. He liked the course, although he got off to a sluggish start and was at the back of the pack at one stage. Erling Norberg eased his way past his rivals to take the lead, and as the last jump approached, seemed poised for victory and a place in the next round. The Swede crashed on landing. Igor Korotkov of Russia in yellow was coming up behind rapidly, and he also lost control. Those two falls allowed Armin Neiderer from Switzerland to come through and win. Neiderer couldn't believe his good fortune. He'd come over the hill in third and crossed the line first. Juni Pelanin of Finland in the blue also fell over, and Erling Norberg and Korotkov were carried over the line by their momentum. It needed a photograph to confirm that the Russian Korotkov had pipped Erling Norberg to qualify in second place. Watch how Korotkov dives for the line to make it. Three French skiers went in the second of the quarterfinals. It would be a straightforward win for Jean-Frédéric Chapuis in red. Second was Jonathan Meadle in yellow, with Jonas de Verasso, also of France, third. Brady Lehman of Canada in red never looked in any danger winning his race. Arno Bovalenta from France in the green was second. Skiers from Slovenia and Germany would complete the lineup for the semi-finals. Slovenia's Filip Flizar in red claimed victory, with Florian Eigler also going through. The French challenge was looking ominous. Three riders were into the semi-finals, and all of them would make the final. Jean-Frédéric Chapuis led their charge, easing to victory, with Jonathan Meadle following him home. Igor Korotkov tried to hang on to them but failed in his bid. The second semi-final involved Filip Flizar of Slovenia with his distinctive moustache. He was ready to go, but within metres his challenge ended. Two skiers from three for a place in the final. Brady Lehman in red won, with Arno Bovalenta of France in the blue bib also making it through. The lineup for the final, three skiers from France and Brady Lehman from Canada out to stop them. It was the contest for gold. Jean-Frédéric Chapuis was wearing the green bib and he would jostle for the lead with Arno Bovalenta in blue in the early stages. The course, 1,200 metres long, with a series of big jumps and tight bends. A demanding route and the pressure on in the Olympic final. The men's ski cross events had been highly enjoyable to watch for spectators, and now it was heading for its conclusion. Jean-Frédéric Chapuis was in the lead, followed by Meadl and Bovalenta. French athletes first, second and third. Brady Lehmann trying to break that dominance. Lehmann fell on a turn near the end, and by that stage there was no way that Chapuis was going to surrender his lead. Chapuis came home first to become the new Olympic champion, Bovalenta taking silver and Meadl the bronze. The French supporters celebrated a triumph for their ski cross team. French skiers occupying the top three places, and a day they would never forget.
Дамы и господа, приветствую!